So is this our planet's twin? Check out all these awesome lunar eclipse photos. And someone has a birthday.
Hello, space fans. Welcome to another edition of Space Fan News.
So what's this I hear about Earth's twin being found? Well, let's slow down a bit and take a look at what was actually announced. On the 17th of April, scientists with the Kepler Space Telescope hosted a live teleconference where they shared the news that they have confirmed the discovery of an Earth-sized planet orbiting a star in its habitable zone. But what does that mean? Well, first, let's take a look at the star. Kepler-186f is orbiting an M dwarf star, which is also known as a red dwarf, though I didn't see any signs of Rimmer or Crichton. Now, these M dwarf stars are much smaller than a star like our sun, but it's also much cooler. Now, I know what you're thinking. If this star is so much cooler, how can the planet be inside the habitable zone? Well, that's the kicker. Even though the planet is around the size of Earth, its orbit is actually around the size of Mercury, meaning that it's receiving around the same amount of solar radiation that could potentially allow for liquid water to exist. Now, I underscore potentially for a few really good reasons. First of all, we only really know the size of this planet, which is around 10% larger than Earth in diameter. But we don't have any idea about what the mass is or what the composition of this planet is. Furthermore, we have no idea what the atmospheric conditions are on this planet, or even has one. It could be a thin, wispy one, kind of like Mars, or it can be this choking, acidic, nasty place like Venus that's caught in this runaway greenhouse effect. There's just simply not enough information to us right now to know if it's anything like a cousin or a twin or whatever family metaphor to Earth that you want. Thousands of you joined us as we did the live broadcast of the total lunar eclipse. While I was hosting here in Los Angeles, David Dickinson joined us from Florida, and astrophysicist Katie Mack joined us from Melbourne, Australia. We're able to stream views live through all of it, as well as watching the eclipsed moon rise in Australia while we're watching it overhead here in the United States. Really awesome. Now, while that was going on, we were getting a ton of pictures in from Twitter and on Google+, and I really wanted to show those off in Space Fan News. So please enjoy. Guess who turned 24? Well, I'm sure a lot of you did, but I'm talking about the Hubble Space Telescope. On the 24th of April, 1990, Hubble launched from Florida on board the Space Shuttle Discovery. Now, it was originally planned to have launched in the 80s, but since the Challenger disaster happened, it had to be put on ice for a little while until the safety requirements were able to go back up. Now, after its launch, there were a total of 5 service missions that went up there to either do repairs on or add functionality and add equipment to the Hubble Space Telescope. This includes the Wide Field Camera 3, which supercharged the space telescope to be able to see a wider chunk of the spectrum, including infrared and ultraviolet light. Now, Hubble has given us an amazing new way of looking out at the universe. With the Hubble Deep, Ultra Deep, Extreme Deep fields reveal that what appears to be empty space is actually teeming with galaxies. This allowed us to get a better understanding of the formation and evolution of those galaxies. On top of that, Hubble was used to observe the accelerated expansion of the universe, for which the 2011 Nobel Prize in Physics was awarded. So even today, we're finding new ways to use Hubble, now utilizing the warping of space-time due to dark matter caused by extremely massive galaxy clusters that allow us to look further back in space and time than ever before. So here's to you, Hubble. Happy 24th birthday. Do you want more Space Fan News? Well, make sure to subscribe or follow our Tumblr on Space Fan News Live. You can also find us out on Twitter at SpaceFanNews and join the almost 2 million followers we have over on Google+. Thank you all for watching, and as always, keep looking up.